So Jason, it was a defeat last week against Falkirk. Looking back on the game this week, how did you view the 90 minutes?
Pretty much even up until they scored. And we sort of stepped off a wee bit, stepped off the gas, whatever you want to call it. And then we came out second half and I thought it was a little bit even again, and they managed to get a second goal, which sort of deflated us. Gaffer made a few changes and we managed to sneak a goal back. Hopefully it was going to get a second, but it wasn't to be.
So that's the end of the first quarter now. 7 points on the board, 8th in the table. What's your general overview of how the season started? Is it a slower start than you expected?
I wouldn't say slower. Maybe points-wise, yes. But performances have not been that bad. You know, we've played relatively good football in some parts of the games. Just results haven't gone our way, and that's the thing we need to change. Is, you know, obviously it's a results-based game, and hopefully we can start picking up 3 points as offsider.
Obviously, as one of the more experienced players within the squad, you've played with Livingston in this league for 2 or 3 seasons, so you'll know what the next steps are in the next quarter. Is it just about getting that next victory and hopefully boosting the confidence?
Yeah, victories are a must. 3 points is what we need on Saturday, and hopefully that can kickstart. We had a couple of results a few weeks back, obviously, with a cup game as well, you know, and hopefully that would have kick-started us. Unfortunately, we took a defeat against Falkirk. Derbies are always massive. Unfortunately, we come away with a defeat in that one. But there's plenty more of them, so, like I say, Saturday's the main focus for us.
This big game on Saturday against Hibs, they're top of the league, but they have only won one game in the last 6. Does the players take confidence from that, and or does form kind of go out the window in these games?
Well, we can take confidence from that, you know. When we played them at their place, you know, at the beginning of the season, we didn't think they were that much better than us, you know. We had chances to win the games, and we didn't take our chances, and they took theirs, and that was pretty much how the game went. You know, I thought it was pretty even. The players performed magnificently, you know. The work rate and the effort they put in was second to none.
If my math skills are right, that'll be your 50th appearance on Saturday if you play it. And that's a pretty good milestone for being at the club for just over a year. I'm guessing that you'll just be looking to kick on from that now and hopefully reach the next milestone.
Yeah, that's, you know, I have personal goals, and my goal at the moment is to play every game I possibly can. You know, that was the aim at the beginning of the season, unfortunately, due to suspension at the beginning, and obviously the Queen of the South game came to a short end. But from that moment on, you know, I wanted to play every single game, and that's all I can try and do for the club, is try and play as many games as I can and perform well.
Despite being probably the only natural left-back within the squad, you've got competition from Lewis Martin, Ewan Sparks stepping up from the under-20s as well and pushing you hard as well. Competition for places is good, and it's a strong squad all over the park.
Yeah, strong squad. Competition for places, like you say, is massive. You know, we need that throughout, because, like you say, this Championship League is hard, it's tough, it's grueling. You know, we might get a lot more injuries than we did. Hope, touch wood, we don't, but we might get a lot more injuries than we did last year, and suspensions are going to come thick and fast. It's just the style of the Championship, you know, and it's one of the toughest leagues to be involved in. You know, 2 wins could put you up into 5th, 4th place, 2 defeats could put you back down to 8th or 9th. It's a variety of I don't know what I'm going to say there, but basically, competition is great for the squad.
It's expected to be a big crowd on Saturday. Hibs have sold over 2,000 tickets, I believe. Is the Dunfermline fans turning up in numbers and getting right behind the players from the start? Does that boost the players just going in from the warm-up and seeing such a big crowd?
Yeah, it does. I think it helps, you know, that 12-man scenario. With Saturday especially, you know, with Falkirk, we just played, you know, their fans got behind them straight from the go, and it set the tempo for them, and we had to match that. And I think that could help us on Saturday, you know, if we get the fans behind us straight away, put them under a bit of the pressure. You know what Hibs fans are like, as soon as they don't play well, they start to crack a wee bit, and the fans are on the back and stuff like that. So the more fans we can bring through the gate, the better it is for us.
Thanks, Jason.
No problem, thank you very much.